Hello, this is a quick explainer video to show how to create a signature stamp brush in Procreate. Phil asked me to do this and I thought I'd share it on here so that others can see. So if we go straight into Procreate, we're going to create a canvas. We're going to have a square canvas. So if you press the plus in the top right and then choose square, that will give us a square canvas. Now the first thing we're going to do is create a completely black layer. This just makes it easier for us to see what we're doing because we're going to be working in white because we output this as a white transparent PNG file at the end. So create another layer above that and then change your brush to white. And then it's just a case of designing whatever it is we're looking to create. Now I like to use the vine charcoal when I'm just roughing something out. So with the vine charcoal, I'm just going to create an outline of something, something like this, and then maybe something like this. It doesn't have to be too precise because, of course, this is just a rough guide so that we can see what we're doing. So we're just roughing out a design and we might end up with some lines in here as well. But we can decide that in just a moment and maybe also just something there. Then pop a line in here and of course we can just make that horizontal by adding a secondary tap to the screen. And as it was Phil that asked me how to do this, let's just have his name along here. Again, it's just rough, just so we can see what we're doing. And then what I might actually do is just center all of that in the screen on the canvas there. So having done that, I can reduce the opacity on this so that I've just got it as a guide layer. And then I'll create another layer above. And I'm now going to use the monoline pen. I've got it set all the way down to the smallest size and the opacity all the way up. That's important just so that I get the full colour that I want. And then I can actually come in here and start marking out my design. And of course, if you make any mistakes as you go along, you can easily correct those. But just drop the colour in on that. Make sure that I'm happy with this here. If I'm not, or if I add in too much colour, I can, of course, use an eraser on the monoline tool and come in and erase back out any areas that I want to be see-through. And I might just also add a dot there just using the dab of the monoline tool. So in now to the brush head. And I can just drop some colour in there. I could then, if I wanted to, just erasing out of this just to get some lines through there and maybe a dot at the end of the brush as well. Then add in our splashes of paint as we go. There we are. Another one just here. Okay, it just needs some taken out of it just to give it a highlight in effect. So we can do that on each of these. And you can be as particular as you like on this. I'm just doing it very quickly just to get something to show you the technique for creating the image. So now we're on to the name and I'm going to use the script pen just for this. And if I just there we are, we've got that. What I can do now is that bottom layer that was my guide, I can turn that off and you can see I've now got this signature that I want to use. Now I can add as much detail or as little detail as I want through that. I can also add a drop shadow if I want, which I'll show you just quickly. Because we want it all transparent, we don't want to add a black layer in between to create a gap. So if I just duplicate this layer, and then with the lower of those two, if I select it and tap it away, I've just moved it away from the edge of that one, I can now actually go back onto my top layer, select, so that I've selected that outline, turn it off, and then using select on the next layer down, and if I use the erase tool with something like a hard brush, because I know that's going to erase out very quickly for me, I can actually just erase everything except the edge of that bottom layer. Then if I come off the selection, turn on my top layer again. Now what I can do with my bottom layer is just move it so that I get a little drop shadow. And the thing that I notice straight away that I don't like particularly is the way that it's given me a drop on some of the dots. So I can just adjust that. I can also, while I'm on that lower layer, erase out anything that I don't like using the mono eraser. So for example, I might not want that bit in the middle of those. I can get rid of those quite quickly, and I might also not want them in the brush itself, just on the bottom of the brush edge, just so that it's not too much and too dense. So I can get rid of those like that, and I can just make a couple of adjustments so that I'm happy with the outlining. If we've got a hole in the middle of this, we don't necessarily want to be able to see something underneath, because that's not the purpose of it. There we are. Okay, make sure I'm happy with where the drop shadow is on the name, and I think that all looks okay, certainly for the purposes of this. So I've now got two layers, and I can turn off my black layer and then turn off the background color as well. And what we're left with is just our white layer. So what we're now going to do is to export that as a transparent PNG file. So go to the wrench tool in the top left, then share, and the second to bottom is PNG. Just click on that, and we're going to save the image, and it will save it to the camera roll. So now we can come back in and create a new canvas. This time it can be screen size. And then what we're going to do, add some colour to the brush. It can be any colour whatsoever. Decide where you want your new brush, because wherever you create it is where it's going to be. For me, I'm going to drop it in on calligraphy here. So top right, see where it says plus. If you click on plus, it then brings us to an untitled brush. Shape source is where we're going first, and you'll see that it says there's three to choose from. We want insert photo, which is the bottom one. And if we go to our photos, now you won't see what we've just created because it was a transparent PNG on a transparent background. So it's going to be the last picture, and in fact, it's to the right of this little drawing of a purse that I've done today. So just click to the right of it, and you can see it's brought in that brush that we just created. Now we need to choose a grain source, and if you choose swap from Pro Library in the middle there, you can then choose from this Pro Library. Now you can try all different ones and see how it goes. For the purposes of this, we're going to choose blank, which gives us a solid fill. And we choose blank, and that then gives us, if we look on source, you'll see a preview of our brush at the top, which of course is not what we want it to look like. So we've just got to make a couple of changes to some of the settings on the brush. if we have a look first of all through each of them, and you make sure that you're matching what I'm doing. I want to change first of all spacing, and I'm going to change that up to around 85-86%, like that. The rest of it I'm happy with. On to shape, that all looks all right, I'm happy with that. The grain is fine, dynamics is all right. The pencil, yep, that's all right, so make sure you're matching that. And then in general, I just want to make another couple of changes. When you come down to size limit, we're going to increase that up to around 650, something like that. And we're also going to bring the minimum up to around 20-25. And the reason being that if you've got your brush size on minimum, you want it to show something on the page. If it has zero there, then it's actually going to show nothing when you set your brush size to minimum. Okay, so now we, just before I click off that, you'll see at the top it says Untitled Brush. If we just tap on that, we can rename this to Phil's Brush. Call it what you want, click Done. And we've now got Phil's brush. Okay, we've created a brush, and if I've got this on the full size and I click on it, you'll see it gives me a nice stamp of the brush I created. And if I reduce the size, I can also of course change the color. I can then add other brushes as well, all the way down to the minimum size, which is very small, but you get the idea. So whatever colour you want, you can now create a brush based on your artwork. There we are. That's creating a brush stamp in Procreate. I hope that was useful, but if you've got any questions, then please do ask. Thanks very much.